KAMR NBC4 News. This is Today in Amarillo.
A local school is shutting down after 24 years in the community. And Abandoned Canyon is passed on texting while driving. Today in Amarillo starts now.
Good morning. It's Tuesday, May 8th. I'm Morgan Schutters.
And I'm Nick Lilia. Good morning. Thanks so much for waking up with us here on KAMR NBC4's Today in Amarillo.
This morning, we're talking about the Canadian River Music Festival going on this weekend. More details just ahead.
And I know yesterday I talked about turkeys and I made fun of myself about 30 minutes ago, but I just want to thank Connie Barnett again for sending me those really cool pictures. Very, very cool. A beautiful bird.
We love to hear from our viewers.
Exactly. And it is a very, very cool pick. But let's take a look at the bus stop forecast this morning. It's National Teacher Day, so as the kids do head out the door, maybe give them an extra apple to take to the teacher. Cloudy and cool with a few raindrops out there, anywhere from the upper 40s to the mid 50s. Northeast winds at about 5 to 10 miles an hour. We do have a little batch of light showers moving down I-40 toward Amarillo. I think most of that will fall apart by the time it gets here, but maybe grab the umbrella as you head out the door as well, just in case. I'll have a full forecast in a couple of minutes, but for now, let's toss it on back to Morgan.
Thanks so much, Nick. In the news this morning, students at Arbor Christian Academy will now have to find a new school. Officials say they're closing the school's doors for financial reasons and that enrollment has declined. School spokespersons say they have about 290 students enrolled right now, with about 50 people on staff.
The good thing is that Arbor Christian Academy has a 24-year history and legacy of investing in these students, and the things that these students bring with them into the next phase of their life, that will go on and continue beyond the life of the school itself.
Arbor will close its doors for good at the end of the school year. The school has been around for 24 years. Canyon City commissioners have passed a ban on texting while driving. They made that decision at their regular meeting last night. City Manager Randy Criswell says there were several changes to the original proposal. It was amended to allow first responders to use their phones and people who have to use wireless devices for their job.
I am grateful to the City Commission of Canyon for looking into this topic and taking the stand to protect the community of Canyon by putting this ban in place.
Now, it passed on a 3-1 vote. It will go into effect tentatively August 1st after signs are in place. An Amarillo woman is dead and teens behind bars after a hit-and-run accident this weekend, but police say it could have been prevented if the suspect had not been speeding. Officers say 18-year-old Edwin Ortiz was racing when he hit 77-year-old Merlene Hooker Scott's car. The car rolled down the embankment. It happened on the 1600 block of I-40 West and Bowie around 6 Saturday night. Police say after the crash, Ortiz fled the scene. Police are still investigating that accident and other street racing complaints. They say if you're on the road when someone is illegally racing, drive defensively and get out of the way.
Even if an officer is available immediately and close by, it's pretty tough to get a hold of a couple of cars that are speeding down the interstate or down Sauncey or any of the other places where we've dealt with this.
Officers finally tracked Ortiz down at West 16th and Lamar and arrested him. He was booked in the Potter County Jail and charged with failure to stop and render aid and racing causing death. And police say they've had more and more complaints about racing, especially in the Hillside, Colter, Sauncey, and 45th areas. They're putting increased patrols there to crack down on the violators. In the nation, the CIA and the FBI have uncovered and foiled an ambitious airline bomb plot by Al-Qaeda. U.S. officials say they stopped a would-be suicide bomber before a ticket was ever purchased. The plan was to upgrade the underwear bomb that failed to detonate in 2009. Officials say the new bomb was non-metallic, designed to pass undetected through the best airport security. In Washington, the Senate is expected to take up a plan to keep student loan rates from doubling July 1st. House Republicans passed a one-year extension last week, paying for it by cutting from a preventative health care fund. The Senate Democrats' plan would pay for the $6 billion extension by collecting more Social Security and Medicare payroll taxes from the wealthy. The time now is 6:35, so it's time to take a look at your weather. Here's forewarned severe storm team meteorologist Nick Lilia. A little chillier out there this morning, huh, Nick?
Yeah, it is, and we've got a relative cloud deck in effect this morning, so with those northeast